Joining us right now is Amy Chua. She is the author of the new book, Political Tribes. Book is out this week. And Amy, thank you for being here. It's great to see you.
Thanks so much for having me.
Explain what tribalism is. What are you talking about?
Well, the term is used lots of different ways. You can mean like a literal tribe, like the Afghan Pashtun tribes. People often use it to mean an ethnic affiliation, like the Japanese tribe or the Jewish tribe. Or it can just be a modern identity-driven tribe. And all I mean, Becky, is a special kind of group allegiance where your identity becomes so bound up with the group that it's really intense. So that you really feel like these are my people, you know, and kind of like your reaction to the Olympics, right? It's like, we want this team to win. We don't care what anybody says.
I am totally tribal when it comes
to sports. Sports is tribal.
admittedly. But you think we've come to a new era in the United States where everybody is feeling tribal, whether you are a minority or in a majority or any of these things. You think everybody's feeling pressure right now.
Right. So tribalism, it's hardwired in us, and we just can't ignore it. If we don't fight it, we are all tribal. The problem is when tribalism takes over the political system, that's much less healthy. And that's what we're seeing right now, because what happens is so many different groups feel threatened, not just minorities, but whites feel threatened, not just Muslims and Jews and Buddhists, but Christians feel threatened. So when people feel threatened, that's when they retreat into tribalism and they get very insular and more defensive. And the problem, Becky, is when with tribalism, you see everything through your tribal lens and you kind of ignore facts. You want to stick to your team and be loyal to it. And that's preventing us from having some really important national conversations.
First of all, what happened? How did we get to this point? Is it a reflection of the 2008 financial crisis?
That's only a part of it. Honestly, I think we all tend to want to point fingers. I think both sides of the political spectrum are to blame. I don't think there's anybody who's blameless here. And on the left, I think there has been too much focusing on sort of identity mongering, victim worshiping, and people didn't expect, they knew that might take over college campuses, but they didn't expect that to contribute to the rise of Donald Trump. And on the right, you know, a lot of rage mongering, a lot of conspiracy theory peddling. You know, they expected that maybe that's going to stay on conservative, you know, talk media, didn't expect that to contribute to the rise of Donald Trump, too. So the book is really explaining this anti-establishment movement.
Both sides a little conspiracy theory mongering. I mean, unless we do find some collusion. But you know, you should pull up the Bill Murray interview that we did out in
Pebble Beach. Yeah.
Very started similar. Out by saying the country wakes up in the morning. It's a clash of clans. Yeah. Went on to talk about identity politics, how one of the faults of the left is that they pick out groups to say that we represent you and almost exploit that group just to say but we don't represent everyone. But they said almost the identical things that
progressives.
Did you see that interview?
But now I'm going to look it up. I mean, you know, the progressives are making some really important points. There's a lot of problems, but I feel like the discussion, because of our tribalism, we can't really talk about the problems. It's almost like a game of gotcha. Oh, you said the wrong thing. And, you know, I'm a huge fan of immigration in the sense that I'm the daughter of immigrants. I think that it's been a source of our vitality in this country. But I think it's ridiculous if somebody in America can't just express their anxiety and say, you know, I'm worried about immigration. Can we talk about how we do this, how we have limits? You know, at this point, it's like, if you just say that, oh my God, xenophobic, racist, you right. know, and that's just not where we want to be. We really want to be talking.
How do we fix the problem?
Well, I don't think that we should romanticize this, but I think because my work is really looking at tribalism and how it's broken down countries outside the United States, I think both sides have been playing with fire and not realizing it. So the good news is that studies show that if you can just pull people out of their tribes and have them interact as human beings, unbelievable progress can be made. So if you take people who hate each other or politically, but you say, get together and talk about dogs, your pets, or pizza, or your children, people find common ground. Yeah. So I think that's the next step. We have to realize that, you know, we can't see people that we disagree with on the other side of the political spectrum as enemies. Right. I mean, they're just people we disagree with, not un-Americans or immoral people. At that point, we're just going to fracture into two or more.
I've tried to do that with pets, you know, and I brought up my dogs, and then someone, they'll start talking about cats. The stupid cats. You know what I mean? They don't, you know, please
you
come
go.
Over and let me pet you. And they're
those
like,
those people
no.
are infuriated. I know, this is tribalism.
Yeah. So I put out, you know, I've tried to bridge the gap, but they, you know, there's these cat people that I can't.
But that's part of it.
And she's
she
so, with the Olympics,
media.
She's just, ooh,
well,
man. I mean,
less social media yeah. and more human
She doesn't like anyone else yes. winning any medals. It's like, what, those athletes aren't people too? People from
apparently,
the
Netherlands. I'm the only American fan here.
People from Norway, what, we can't watch their achievement and embrace it and celebrate
they
it just because they're not
cheering for them.
Huh?
Tribalism is okay when it comes to the Olympics, right, Amy?
Oh, or how about football teams?
Thank
Have you ever tried talking to people about their football teams,
right.
trying to get them to switch allegiances? That's tribal.
Hey there, thanks for checking out CNBC on YouTube. Be sure to subscribe to stay up to date on all of the day's biggest stories. You can also click on any of the videos around me to watch the latest from CNBC. Thanks for watching.